6 p.m. How you feeling, Brownie?
I'm feeling so good.
Yeah, I'm feeling so good. Yeah, okay. I want to applaud the fact that you actually came earlier than stipulated time. All right. Yeah. I want to personally do that. I appreciate every single person who, you know, comes when I say 2 p.m. Your 2 is 2.
Yeah.
You're not an African with that mentality, okay? Yeah. So I'm listening to your song. I actually like it. I actually like it because of the message. The message in the song, I mean, it kind of, I'll allow you to expatiate on what the message of the song is about, but from what you can hear clearly, that's me and other people because you made the song.
Yeah.
Right, so you know every word you said there. But from what I can hear from the song, it just basically states, you know, how there is the virus, you know, doing its thing, you know, messing up the world.
Yeah.
And then coronavirus has met hunger virus first on ground.
Yeah.
I mean, there is the
We all know that. Hunger virus is born in the other than coronavirus or COVID-19 of a thing. You know, he just came up and he actually woke up a hunger virus. Yeah, being that you in the street and you know how it goes, yeah. Feeling the street, feeling the cries of the street, you know how it goes. So, so being that most people think that we're actually promoting coronavirus or something, but I actually had bad songs, but we needed to, you know, let's just do this and
get into the moment.
Yeah, get into the moment with the people and also and get the mind of the people connecting with the government and so on, you know. A lot of things were in the song that you can actually relate to, and which is actually what is happening presently. Yeah. So, if Corona or COVID-19 should be an artist like me, man, it should be the most popular artist of all time.
Yeah.
Yes. It will be the biggest brand ever.
It will be the biggest thing in the world.
So, I'm very sure that everyone of us, no one is exceeded. Yeah, both big and small, it affected everyone in one way or the other. So everybody knows about it.
And yeah, definitely.
Yeah, he knows definitely. About it. And making hunger virus should explain more better that, you know, showing the damages and the things that it caused during the lockdown and most things that were going on there. You know, that some people that without going out every day that will not have anything to eat for the rest of the day, you know, so it actually affected a lot.
A lot of people, so, and that's what you're trying to communicate in the song.
Yeah, to actually relate to the street and the people.
I like the fact that, you know, you did not release a song that has to do with a woman's behind, like almost every other artist.
It's not like I don't have songs like
it kind
that.
You have songs like that, but yeah. You decided to drop this.
Yeah. For my people, yeah, to show that, yeah, we actually care about them.
Yeah,
we have to sponsor these and push it. Yeah, let others hear our voice, but the government should improve in their work. So I thought many areas in the song.
So. All right, now what difference would you say this song has made?
Well,
in terms of impact.
Impact, and to my own notice, I realized that most people like the song, and they don't just like the song because they like the song. It's about the message and the thing I was passing through. So. I'm thinking that it actually made a bit different, yeah, because I think right now the COVID-19 or lockdown is not like the way it was before, you know, before I dropped the song. So I feel, yeah, it has actually made a big difference.
Made an impact. Yeah. Do you feel this will be the right boost for people to, you know, get to know you a lot better and understand, you know, how you think?
Yeah.
Do you feel this might be a trip to your mind?
I think knowing better, bringing out the song, I never thought of that, but I thought of the people at first, yeah, my people first, because no one is excluded. It actually affected everybody. So I feel doing it this way will make a big impact in every of the story, yeah. So I have to push it this way, and I feel it's the best way to do it.
Okay. Now, that said, before now, what kind of music were you making, and where was your head at? I mean, with the Nigerian music industry, what point did you plan to, you know, pierce through?
Just put your position.
Nigerian music industry, if you listen to most of the songs they do these days, it's just like it's based on one side or something. But yeah, I just believe that I ain't competing with anybody. So I just needed to bring out my own style, my own concept of the song, like make my own, create out my own sound. Yeah, like, yeah, this is me, you know. So it's Afropop, yeah, Afropop.
That's your sound.
That's my sound. And many others coming through, so we just have to, you know,
move with the changing times.
Yeah.
Okay.
But not like, let us just follow up in what's trending, or I'm kind of trying to create out my own style. This is me, Brownie.
Definitely.
Yeah.
All right. Now that said, who do you look up to in the industry at the moment?
Oh,
who do you see and say, you know what? I think this is a great role model.
Yeah. I look up to many artists because I like to identify with success stories. Knowing that
everybody likes to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Knowing that you're good. You see, Burna Boy, Wizkid, that's locally, Burna Boy, Whiskey 2, Baba, those have been people that they have been inspiring me in many ways, locally, internationally. I'll go to Rihanna, Chris Brown. These two have been my personal.
All right.
Okay. Yeah, joke with them.
Okay. So, now, if you were to do a feature with any artist at the moment, who would you feature?
Locally, I will feature Burna Boy. Internationally, should be Rihanna. I don't know why I like the girl. Just love the sound. Her sound just kind of unique to me. So I feel like she's the best for me internationally for now.
Okay. All right. Now that said, well, what's your plan going forward? I mean, you dropped this already, promoting it and whatnot. But what's your plan for your music going forward?
My plan right now, I'm working on my album. And a lot more songs, yeah. But right now, like next month, we'll be dropping a song, Bless Me. That's my next dropping song. And followed by Bana, just in 19. So that's a big, the sound is coming through like a blast. So I've got a lot of songs, a lot of package, man, to unleash.
Okay, so when should we expect the album?
The album, let's say, by the end of the year.
By the end of the year?
Yeah, after dropping my maybe two or three singles of mine.
How long have you been making music for?
It's been a long while. I don't know, I was little.
When was the first time you stepped in the studio to make your own music?
I was 17. That was when I had my first track and my second track. And started involving myself in local shows, trying to show myself. Yeah.
Local shows in what area?
Not quite big shows, but, you know, anywhere.
Where be your base?
Everybody get base. Now
cook
I do. Cook, boy for you.
All right.